Welcome back to the Fenrir Bull Terrier channel. If this is your first time here, my name's Charlotte and I'm a certified canine leader here at FenrirCanineLeaders.com. This channel is dedicated to helping you learn everything you could possibly want to know about the Bull Terrier and then how to become high-level canine leaders that can raise the perfect Bull Terrier. So if you're a lifelong lover, thinking about getting one, or just started your journey with your new Bull Terrier, then this channel is for you. So make sure you hit that subscribe button and turn on the notification bell so you never miss a future Bull Terrier video. So, let's dive into today's video and we'll compare two of the most different breeds in the world and what you should consider when choosing the right canine companion for your home. Can you find two more different breeds in the Bull Terrier and the Labrador Retriever? You'll have a hard time trying, that's for sure. Let's start with the way they look. The Labrador is one of the most popular dog breeds on the planet, and everyone knows what he looks like. He's on the verge between medium-sized and large, with one of the friendliest temperaments you could possibly find. He's an active dog, easy to train, and he loves to retrieve for his own person, or anyone else for that matter. He doesn't really care as long as he gets to retrieve. The Bull Terrier, on the other hand, is one of the most unique exteriors known to man, with that egg-shaped head of his. He's considerably smaller than the Labrador, he's friendly, fairly easy to train, and a lot of fun to be around. Yet there are many differences between these two breeds, but similarities as well. For example, both breeds are active and athletic and loves to be with their people on any adventures. If you're the kind of person who wants more physical exercise, I suggest you take an extra good look at the Labrador. However, he needs more exercise than the Bull Terrier, although the latter by no means isn't any meat couch potato.
Hey guys, very quickly, I just wanted to ask, are you following us over on Instagram? If you're not, there's two accounts I would love for you to check out. The first one is our brand account, at Fenrir Canine Leaders, where you can see more about our industry-leading products that we create. If you're interested in following me personally, that's at I Am Will Atherton, where you can see behind the scenes of me working with some of the most extreme behaviour cases in the world and what it takes to run these kind of YouTube channels. And maybe if you just want to be able to come over and chat with me, that's the place for you. So there'll be links down in the description box for both of our Instagram pages. I'd love for you to come and check them out and hopefully we'll chat over there.
Now, there are quite a few differences between the backgrounds of these amazing breeds. The Labrador Retriever was bred alongside the Newfoundland dog on the Newfoundland Island in Canada to be of assistance to fishermen by retrieving ducks and other related tasks. This gives him an eagerness to please his owner and desire to work with his handler rather than against him. The Bull Terrier, on the other hand, is the result of interbreeding bull-type dogs with various terriers to be used in blood sports. This makes him strong-willed and stubborn and requires a lot of the person who decides to share his or her life with them. It's important to know that while both these breeds do exceptionally well as family pets, they both need mental challenges and stimulation not to get bored. Especially the Lab. He tends to get bored quite easily, and when he does, he tends to get destructive. To fulfill the needs of your dog, regardless which one of these breeds you decide on, you need to encourage in both physical exercise and to challenge them mentally. This can be done by letting them excel in canine sports like agility, obedience, tracking, coursing, etc. If you don't want to be so ambitious, you can still entertain your dog's needs by putting him through mental challenges at home, like searching for his food, hide and seek, and other games. This way you get to spend quality time with your dog at the same time as he gets to work that brain out, and you'll end up with a tired but happy dog. Before I continue to the health of these beautiful breeds, I wanted to remind you that if you want to know more about these breeds specifically, then please follow the channel for each breed and learn everything and more that you can know about them, so that you can make an educated decision on which breed to bring into your life. So, what happens if I bring a Bull Terrier or a Labrador Retriever into my family where there are children present, you may ask? If raised and trained properly, both these breeds would work fine with children. However, the Bull Terrier is quite the powerhouse, and once he reaches a certain speed, it's recommended to take cover, otherwise you'll be knocked off your feet by that cannonball of a dog. Your toddlers are smaller and not as strong as you. The rest, I'll leave to your imagination. The Labrador has size against him, as well as his need for activity and exercise. When he gets excited, toddlers may start flying around the room or the yard. And while it may be amusing to watch, your toddlers may not be equally entertained. But in the end, it's totally up to you how you want your dog, regardless of breed, to interact with your friends and your children. Please remember, it's just as important to teach your children how to behave properly around dogs. It's a two-way communication, after all. And we should never put the responsibility on the dog alone. Okay, so let's move on to the health of the Bull Terrier and the Labrador Retriever. Being considered a larger breed, the Labrador is, as many others, prone to hip and elbow dysplasia. Alongside that, he can also suffer from heart disorders, muscle weakness, various eye conditions, and something called induced exercise collapse that can happen to young adult labs. The most severe issue that can happen is bloat. While this is life-threatening, it needs immediate veterinary attention. So please educate yourself on the symptoms and what to look for so you know what to do just in case this happens to you and your dog. The Bull Terrier, being a smaller dog, has little if any problems with his joints. On the other hand, breeders should test their parent animals for kidney and heart issues. And puppies should be tested for hearing impairment before leaving the breeder. If you take care of your dog properly, both these breeds have a rather long life expectancy. The Labrador can live up to 10 to 12 years, while the Bull Terrier can reach a remarkable 13 years. This is amazing news for you if you want to spend many long, happy years with your dog. A short conclusion of this comparison is that both the Bull Terrier and the Labrador Retriever are amazing family pets. The Bull Terrier might be a bit more laid back on the exercise part, but is a lot of fun to be around. The Labrador may need a lot more exercise and mental stimulation, but is versatile and pure pleasantry to be around. Whichever breed you choose to bring into your life, you're bound to have an amazing time with them. So, I hope you've enjoyed today's video. If so, make sure you hit that like button and get involved down on the comments section below. And don't forget, if you're new here, to make sure you subscribe. We have two dedicated Bull Terrier videos coming here every single week. So, I can't wait to talk to you again on the next episode of The Bull Terrier Show.